Hello, my name is Jan-Frederik Nieburg, and this video summarizes the results of my bachelor's thesis, Development of an Information System for a Fully Automated Stem Cell Production System, and briefly presents the motivation, goals, and the resulting system of this thesis. This thesis was created in collaboration with the Fraunhofer IPT, who are involved in the AutoGrad project for researching stem cell-based cures for degenerative joint diseases. Part of the research includes an automated method of mass-producing stem cells, as high-quality stem cells are very hard to produce consistently by hand due to their sensitivity and their individualistic behavior. The resulting approach is the ARMF, an automated stem cell production plant with a service-oriented architecture. This architecture is pictured on the right with individual agents loosely coupled through a central control unit with a standardized interface. The agents are easily exchangeable, while the control unit offers production planning and monitoring through a user interface. While this architecture allows for the production process to adapt to the needs of a stem cell batch during production, it also creates complex relationships and data exchanges that can become confusing, thus requiring a user interface structuring relevant data. The information collected in the information system in the control unit is used mainly for production monitoring, as it was developed with a conventional assembly system in mind. There is no interface to monitor the development of the product through its measurement data, however, it is crucial to do so in order to conduct research. With this thesis, a web-based information system for the stem cell production plant is developed using model-driven software engineering with MontiGem. This system structures the production data and allows for the monitoring of ongoing production and resources, as well as stem cell batch data. In order to utilize MontiGem, it is necessary to develop a data structure model for the stem cell production. One common approach to production modeling is the product process resource model pictured here. It identifies products, processes, and resources as the fundamental elements of production and depicts their relationship in a very basic manner with the capabilities offered by the resources and utilized in the context of a process, serving as the link between resources and processes. The basic model is the starting point for the underlying data structure and needs to be expanded to fully model the stem cell production system. The resulting data structure is shown here. Attributes for the core elements have been determined, and in order to keep track of the measurement data, a product now has a list of data point objects. The data point class models measurement data through its expansions such as bool and numeric values. In order to represent the utilization of a capability in the context of a process, the class operation was created, containing information about the position in the process and the duration. The execution of a process is modeled as a job, which contains general scheduling information, as well as a list of assignments representing the scheduling of operations onto resources. The class material is added to enable inventory tracking, including a threshold variable at which a stock is considered low, in order to represent changes over time for the status of a resource and the stock of a material. Update classes containing timestamp and newly assumed values have been created. With this data structure, it is now possible to utilize MontiGem in order to create source code for the information system. This graphic shows the link structure of the front end, with the pages for which GUI models have been developed and implemented. The structure of the page is oriented on the product process resource model as well, with the jobs representing the execution of a process. So the pages are a collection of data related to physical instances. The details pages for resources, products, and jobs are accessible through overviews, which contain lists of all objects in the system. The resources can alternatively be accessed through a factory floor graphic and through a list of capabilities. Next, a selection of these pages will be shown as examples. First up is the dashboard with the graphical navigation component, which can be used to access resource details pages, such as the robot page in this case. The resource details page contains a resource load graph with status 2 signaling a resource is busy, 1 idle, and 0 in error. and a resource profile with the name, the logger data and the utilization, as well as a list of capabilities. Furthermore, there are lists for queues, for capabilities that are to be executed, and capabilities that have been executed in the past. Next up are the product details pages. We can navigate to the product's details pages using an overview, and we are presented with graphs for confluency, cell count, glucose, pH value, and viability, showing the development of the batch over time. Additionally, there is a product profile with the name of the product and the time it has spent outside the incubator. There are also boxes in case endotoxins or mycoplasma are detected. The product also has a history showing the station a product has visited and for how long. Lastly, there's the materials overview page, which shows the stock of each material in form of a bar chart. When a material falls below the threshold, the bar turns gray, indicating that the stock is low. In addition to the bar chart, there's also a complete list of all materials with the amount of the material in the system. This concludes the brief overview of the bachelor's thesis, Development of an Information System for a Fully Automated Stem Cell Production System. Thank you for watching.